Hola, Queens. It's your girl, Queen T here, also known as the one and only Fiance Coach. Before I jump into today's content, hit that subscribe button, hit that subscribe button. Happy New Year. We made it to 2022. Yes, we came through. The last couple of years was a little rough, so I'm hoping that 2022 is off to a better start. So far, it's about positive vibes, as always. You know, it's never been about negative vibes. We want positive vibes, and that's why I'm hoping that you're here, because you are walking into kingdom marriage. Whether you're single, whether you're dating, whether you're fiance, or whether you're already a wife who just wants to make a 180 degree turn, you never know. All right, I'm just happy that you are here and that you have hit that subscribe button by now. Yes, I did just bring that up. All right, so queens, today we're going to be talking about wisdom and what that looks like as you are walking into kingdom marriage. I did want to highlight an awesome course that I believe that you should take that has been launched by my best friend, Anastasia. She's also my ministry partner. The course is called New Year, New Me. It's all about leveling up in 2022. All right, and Anastasia is talking about mindfulness, meditation, nutrition, healthy dating, boundaries, self-care, all the things that you want to make sure that you want to do to make sure that this year just goes the best way possible. I don't know about you, but I would already be looking into that course. Go follow Anna on IG at Anna_thelifecoach. And while you're at it, tell her that Queen T sent you so that you can get an additional bonus one-on-one call with Anna. All right. Anna is also a licensed professional counselor, and she's also a licensed and certified life coach. So she's qualified to talk to you ladies about this stuff. So don't sit on it. Jump right on it and do what you need to do. Now, I don't think there's anything wrong with taking tidbits on qualities about this individual that you want to marry, but to say that, oh, Jesus, I want my husband to be exactly like Devon Franklin or Pastor Torrey Roberts, I urge you not to do that. Please don't do that. It's unfair to your kingdom partner. It's unfair to what you two are trying to build with one another. It's not fair. And it also is kind of like idolatry. And that's what you want to stay away from. You are not out here to idolize someone else's marriage. You're out here being your own version of true wife goals. Because trying to be like someone else is miserable. Because you can never live up to what someone else's capacity is. You know, like, I'm not going to be Megan Good. I don't know how to act. You know, that's just not my forte. You know, but, you know, I think she's a beautiful woman. And there are things and qualities about her that I do like. However, to say that, oh, I want to be a wife just like Megan Good, or I want my husband to be just like Devon Franklin, is not the way to go. So I'm urging you, do not compare your husband or your marriage to someone else's. Do not put somebody else's marriage on a pedestal and use that as like this something you're idolizing, like a goal. You know, we say relationship goals, but we really need to be careful with what we mean when we say relationship goals, because you don't want anybody else's relationship except your own. So number one, again, is do not compare your husband or your marriage to these people on social media. And another way to put that is idolizing someone else's marriage. Just don't do it. Number two, giving up your viewpoint for God's viewpoints. I've listed Proverbs 3:5 right here. And when I listed Proverbs 3:5, it came to my mind, do not lean on your own understanding. Now, a lot of times we tend to jump to conclusion about what we think somebody meant when something was done. And it can be irrational. Sometimes it can be rational. But again, if you're using your feelings and you're not really thinking about it, thinking it through, it's best to just ask God what he thinks about it, you know. Ask God, what was this person's intentions when they said this and they did this? You know, be real with God. Say, God, it made me feel this way. I didn't like how it made me feel when this was done or this was said. But God, I need for your viewpoint to come into the forefront, because I'm a little limited and I'm feeling a bit like I don't really know how to think this through. And it's making me want to react a certain way. So allowing yourself to lose control so that God can have control is the best way to act in wisdom, you know, because you can immediately just jump to your natural number one instinct that came to your mind with your viewpoint about something, and you can totally be wrong, and you just don't want to be in that type of space. You don't want to have that type of energy. You want God to lead your life. You want to be a wife who doesn't do anything foolishly, all right? You want to be someone that walks everything out and know that, okay, I'm doing this because I believe it's God's best intention for the situation. Number three is knowing the right time and right place. Right time and right place. What am I talking about, ladies? It's being aware, not just being self-aware, but it's also being conscious about what's happening around you. It's being, let's just step out of kingdom marriage for a second. We're talking about, you're not only going to be interacting with your husband, you know, consistently, you're going to be interacting with people in the world. So you need to be aware of like where people are. Like, are people a little mentally out of it? Like, is this the right time and right place to have the discussion or to bring something up? Like, is this the, you know, even with services, is this the type of business I want to like give this service to me, want to allow to provide the service for me? Like, you just need to be aware. Is this the right time and right place? Am I safe? Is this person mentally there? You know, these are things you need to think about. But when we're talking about kingdom marriage, we should be thinking about, okay, if your husband had a bad day from work, you shouldn't be complaining about he didn't take the trash out this morning. If he just told you that he had a bad day, you know, and he don't feel like eating, don't complain that, oh, I just cooked this meal for X amount of hours and now you don't want to eat. Sis, he had a bad day. You know, listen to what he's saying to you, just as you should be open to communicate with him about what's going on with you. The right time and the right place is everything. you know, being aware of what's going on with the people that are around you, the people that are in front of you, and also being aware of what's going on within you. I think I used this in a video before. It was shared by my best friend, Anastasia. She talked about halt, not doing anything when you're hungry, angry, lonely, or tired. You know, you have to be aware. Are the people around you hungry, angry, lonely, or tired? These are things that you should be considering. When you have something on your mind, it just may not be the right time and right place to bring it up or address it. You know, ask God to help you find the time and the moment to bring it up. You know, maybe there's something that's pressing that you really wanted to discuss that day and you really don't think you can hold on to it. I'm here to tell you, you can hold on to it. You know, lift it to God, tell him like, hey, I really wanted to discuss this. You know, something's bothering me and, you know, I don't know what to do. I don't know how to bring it up. God will find a way for you to segue into the conversation that is you're trying to figure out the best time to have. And I think that's honestly the best thing to do. You know, with Kingdom Marriage, being aware of your partner. They have flaws. You know, they have feelings. They're going through things as well. You have your life together as one, but you both have totally individual lives when it comes to if he's at work. You don't know what he got going on at work. He don't know what you got going on at work. You have to be aware of the pressures that life is pressing on both of you. All right. So number three, knowing the right time and the right place. Number four, always wanting to be right doesn't always help you or the marriage win, sis. All right. Ladies. There are a couple of us who are unofficial members of the FBI. And yes, I do say unofficial members because I don't know about y'all. Back in the day, if one of my girlfriends told me that her man was doing blah, blah, blah and X, Y, and Z, let me tell you, with the quickness we had information on that dude and that blah, blah, blah that he was doing within less than 5 minutes, all right? That's why I say we are unofficial members of the FBI. And the reason I mention this is because as soon as we get into a debate with our boo, our husband, and we want to prove that we're right, we're very thorough. We know how to find the facts. We know how to find all the information that shows why our theory of what we're saying is accurate. And I'm here to tell you, doing that all the time is annoying. Like, you don't always have to be right. I'm going to be honest with you. If you are a person that feels like you always have to be right when you know you're right and you don't, you know, when you know you're right, you always got to prove it. And being right to you means more than anything. Marriage is not for you. And I didn't even say kingdom marriage. I said marriage. Marriage is not for you because marriage is not about being right. You have to realize this person, you know, survived X amount of years without you, you know, and their way seemed to work just as well. Sometimes it's about compromise. And a good friend of mine gave me this advice. She said that choose your battles carefully. And she told me this when I was still dating my now husband. And I really realized the value in that. She's a married woman as well. And she told me to choose my battles carefully. There are just some things that just let that man think he right. Like, it's just, you know, if he arguing that, you know, the blueberry waffle is better than the cinnamon waffles, girl, just let him think that, okay, because me over here know that the cinnamon waffles is the hottest thing on this earth. But if he think blueberry is the best, okay, enjoy your blueberry. I know it was something silly, but it came to my mind just to give y'all, like, choose your battles carefully. Like, is it really something that is, like, is it about your bank accounts? Okay, if it's bank account talk, then that's serious talk. But if it's something that's really foolish about, I don't know, the washing machine, for instance, me and my husband got into it about the cycles that you wash the clothes on. And it was really foolish. And you know what I say? This man gonna wash the clothes the way he wanna wash them, and I'm gonna wash the clothes the way I wanna wash them. Because guess what? The washing machine is still going to wash the clothes. Regardless of what cycle we put it on, it's gonna have water in there. We both know to put soap powder in there. Boom, voila, clean clothes. If he chooses a different cycle than I choose, go ahead, do you, boo. I love you. Thank you for doing laundry because it ain't a lot of men who know how to do it, you know? So it's just things like that. Like, you want your marriage to win, and choosing your battles carefully and knowing, like, what's worth the time for you to go look up your thesaurus and encyclopedia and to bring all the, you know, doing your Google Scholar searches and stuff like that. Girl, just Just let that man think he right. Just let him think he right. If it's not going to change anything, just give him that win. Let him keep that S on his chest and keep it moving. All right? So that is number four. Always wanting to be right doesn't always help you or the marriage win. Because when you always want to be right, it helps. It actually makes you and your marriage suffer. It makes your partner suffer too. Because they feel like you always in competition. And let me tell you, men don't like being in competition with their wives. They shouldn't have to. You don't have to compete. You don't have to prove anything to him. He chose you because he knew how intelligent you were. You have to remember, okay, he knows this about me. I don't have to prove this to him. I know this about me. Keep it moving. Number five, don't be impulsive with decisions or responses. Yes, Queen T, I'm talking to you. I'm literally talking to myself, y'all, because this is something that Queen T struggles with. Queen T, when it comes to like people coming at Queen T sideways, I'm with the quickness. I had like these quick responses. Back in the day, I had these quick responses and I would just say things sideways back. You know, you wasn't going to get the last word with me. And that's what it was about, the last word. And it's just like, why does the last word even matter? Again, it goes back to number four. It doesn't help you or the marriage win. It just makes you both suffer. So not being impulsive, literally taking time to check in with yourself and check in with God about how should I respond to this? Is this even worth a response? I've learned that the most powerful response is not responding at all. And leaving people on red, okay, if you got an iPhone, you know what I'm talking about. If you got a Galaxy, I don't even got time to explain this to you. But leaving people on red, it is like powerful, all right? Leaving people on red is powerful because they can't take back what they said or did. But the fact that you didn't do anything leaves you innocent in the situation. Innocent. But let me tell you what feels worse. When you say something or you do something so impulsively and then you feel bad about it. Have you ever done that before? Like you said something and you feel bad about it or you did something and you just like, dang, like I was so hot-headed in the moment. I didn't even think about it and I wish I never did it. I'm telling you, it's not worth it because you can apologize to somebody, but something you can't do is erase what was done. You know, you don't want to cause unnecessary drama, unnecessary hurt. You just don't need that negativity in your life and your husband don't need it in his. You want kingdom marriage. This is about God's purpose, not your own. We talked about submission in the last two videos, and it's not only about women submitting, but it's about man and woman submitting to God's mission. You know, the overall mission is God's mission, not that of our own, not having one up on your husband or having one up on somebody else's. And I hope that as you're hearing this wisdom, you realize that it's not just about how you interact with your husband, but it's how you interact with people. You have to realize that these are God's people on this earth, and we will be judged how we interact with God's children, even if we like them or if we don't like them. It's not up to us. We are judged by the way we treat God's children, including your husband. Your husband is God's child, and you should love him as such. All right, so I just want to go over them. I know I went over a little time. So the first one is do not idolize someone else's marriage, especially these people on social media. Stop doing it now. If you need to unfollow somebody that you feel like is a relationship goals for you, do it. I'm telling you, please do it. It is so unhealthy when you keep comparing you and the person that you're marrying or the person you're married to someone else. It's not good. It's not good at all. Number two, give up your viewpoints for God's viewpoints, allowing God's viewpoints to triumph your viewpoints because our viewpoints, our hearts, and our minds are flawed. Number three, knowing the right time and right place to have a discussion and to implement actions. All right, that is a very wise thing to do, knowing the right time and the right place. Number four, always wanting to be right does not always help you or the marriage win. Because when you always want to be right, you and your partner end up suffering. And number five, don't be impulsive with your decisions or responses. All right? So take your time and all of it. If there's anything I've learned about Proverbs, it's about having patience. It's about being mindful. And it's about just doing everything with allowing God to lead. You know, we have gotten through these X amount of years. Thank God we made it through COVID. You know, but we wouldn't have got through it if it wasn't for God. Trusting God to lead you in everything, including your marriage, is the wisest thing that you can do, Kingdom Wife. All right. So I love y'all. Make sure that you share this video with your granny, your auntie, and your bestie. Hello. Make sure you go take Anastasia's Level Up course, New Year, New Me. Follow her on IG at @Anna_thelifecoach. And you can also follow me, Queen T, on IG at @TheBeyoncéCoach. That's my time. Love you, ladies. This is on Wise and Kingdom Marriage. So, the Fiancé Coach connecting you to your true life goals. Let's roll.